Chapter 17 Hanuman meets his match. Now safely inside the palace grounds, Hanuman jumped out of the water pot and quickly increased his size. Appearing as if he had fallen from the sky, he landed right in the middle of the army. They attacked him from all sides, but within a few seconds, Hanuman reduced them all to powder. Hanuman believed that there were no other attackers. But like a thunderbolt, a young Vanara warrior appeared out of nowhere and challenged Hanuman. His physical features were surprisingly similar to Hanuman's. Hanuman was astonished and thought,
"How did a Vanara end up in this land of demons? And why does he so closely resemble me?"
Wishing to quickly remove this one remaining obstacle, Hanuman attacked. However, he found it difficult to overcome this opponent. They fought for a long time until both were exhausted and leaned against opposite walls to rest. Hanuman recovered a bit sooner and said in a soft voice,
"O warrior, we will fight again, let it be so. But I am curious, how could you, a Vanara, come to Patala? Who are your parents? What's your name?"
Though hesitant, the younger one finally spoke softly and slowly.
"Sir, though I have been fighting against you, my respect for you has not diminished. I do not know the reason for that. I am the son of Hanuman, who is the most famous servant of Sri Rama. My mother is Dirghadehi, a Gandharva, a celestial singer. My name is Matsya Vallabha."
Hanuman was shocked to hear these words. He asked himself,
"How can a son be born to me without my knowledge? What great shame to me that he says I am his father. And yet this courageous fellow does resemble me."
Feeling puzzled and slightly sad, Hanuman said,
"Tell me in detail about yourself."
Matsya Vallabha said,
"Once upon a time, Saint Matanga was angry with Dirghadehi, a Gandharva virgin. He cursed her to become a female fish. She prostrated to the saint, prayed to him for mercy. The saint was pacified and he said,
Matsyakaram Dirghadehi Drutva Lavana Sagare Pranamananjaneyasya Kripaya Shapamubhava.
O Dirghadehi, you will live your life as a fish in the ocean of salt water. By the mercy of Lord Hanuman, you will be liberated from this curse."
Matsya Vallabha continued,
"She was transformed into a big fish and eagerly awaited the fortune of the darshana, the divine vision of Hanuman, the best devotee of Lord Rama. For days, she incessantly sang a bhajan addressed to him.
Hanumana Murali Numan Hanuman Voyani Hanuman Hanumana Murali Numan Hanuman Voyani Hanuman
Yuga Yuga Mula Niva Kadavata Prati Ramunaku Pantavata
Gandamadanam Nihilanta Mullokane Konuvanta
Hanumana Moravinuma Hanumavoyani Hanuma
Asuvarchale Nisatiyanta Brahmacharyame Nivratamanta
Brahmarshulu Nishishulata
Brahma Padavi Adi Nidanta
Hanumana Moravinuma Hanumavoyani Hanuma
Kanaka Kadalika Aranya Mula Parijata Tarumula Mula
Polichandi Bakula Tanga Mula Nilichadu Sachidanandudata
The refrain, Hanuma Namora Vinuma, Hanuma Oyani Anuma. Oh Hanuman, kindly listen to my appeal, kindly respond to my prayers. Verse 1, Yuga Yuga Mulani Vokadavata, Prati Ramunaku Bantavata, Gandha Madanamuni Illanta, Mullokamule Koluvanta. You are the immortal one, existing through all ages. However, you take several forms whenever Lord Vishnu incarnates as Lord Rama in each Treta Yuga during every Kalpa, the repeating cycle consisting of all four Yugas. You reside in a subtle form on the mountain Gandhamadana doing penance. You are all pervasive in the three worlds at all times. Verse 2. Asuvarchale ni sati anta, brahmacharya me ni vratamanta, brahma shulu ni shishulata, brahma padavi adi nidanta. Suvarchala is your wife. Both of you have always observed the vow of strict celibacy. Great seers are your disciples. You are going to be the future Lord Brahma. Verse 3. Kanaka kadalika aranyamula, Parijata taru mulamula, kolichadi bhaktula dendamula, nilachadi sachidanandavata. Sometimes you stay in the gardens of golden banana trees. At other times, you sit under the Parijata trees. However, you always remain in the pure hearts of your devotees. You are the repository of Sat, Chit, Ananda, truth, knowledge, bliss. The young Vanara went on to say,
while Dirghadehi was singing, Shri Hanuman flew over the ocean on his way to Lanka in search of Sita. Many sea creatures, including my mother, were looking up to the sky to catch a glimpse of this great soul Hanuman. Heavy perspiration formed on Shri Hanuman's forehead and he wiped it off with his fingers. Drops of his sweat sprinkled down and fell straight into the mouth of Dirghadehi, who had been watching with utmost concentration for a long time. The moment she swallowed the drops, she became pregnant. In due course, I was born to her and she was relieved of the curse. My mother knows the past and the future. For some reason unknown to me, she brought me to Mairavana and arranged for my job here. By her command, I am employed here as a gatekeeper, leading a happy life. I have revealed my entire story. Now, what about you?
Hanuman was wonderstruck and spellbound for some time. Finally, he said,
Child, I am the same Hanuman you mentioned. I am the servant of Lord Rama, and it is only for his sake that I came here. Mairavana has used his power of Maya, illusion, and abducted Sri Rama and Lakshmana while they were asleep by sprinkling a powder to make them unconscious. By mistake, I permitted him entry to see them. Now, even at the cost of my own life, it is my responsibility to take my lord back to Lanka. In this context, you decide what righteous action to take.
Matsyavallabha was astounded by these words and prostrated to his father performing Sashtanga Vandana, the way of prostrating, lying down with extended hands and with the forehead, chest and legs touching the ground. Then he praised Hanuman.
Ajnana tamasandoham bhavataiva yuyodahi tvadunmilita netrankah chantavyota pitasvaya.
My dear father, blinded by the darkness of ignorance, I fought against you. Now, by your grace, my eyes are open. Please forgive me.
He continued,
Sir, I am your son. Kindly forgive me for fighting against you. I no longer wish to be a servant of my Ravana, who abducted Lord Rama and Lakshmana. To kill such mean demons like him is the most righteous act.
Hanuman gently lifted up his son and said,
My son, for some unknown reason, as long as I was fighting with you, I did not feel like striking you hard. By the boons of the celestials, none can defeat me in any war. It is only because you are my son that you withstood my blows and remain alive. Your decision is the most righteous one. Hence, I bless you to have 8 sons who will be as powerful as you.
Then Matsyavallabha offered to take Hanuman inside the palace. Hanuman refused, saying,
My son, it would not be good for you to do so, as one must not defy Prabhuniti, the moral of service. While fighting, I did not use my full power, so you are not actually defeated. But since you choose to no longer fight, stand aside as one who is defeated. It is not righteous for you to be with me, so do not accompany me. If I need help, surely Sri Rama is there.
Hanuman took leave of his son and proceeded alone. He increased his form to a gigantic size and looked around the palace grounds. He spotted Mairavana's inner palace. Without a moment's hesitation, Hanuman jumped through a palace window and landed in the main hall. Mairavana was shocked by the sudden appearance of Hanuman, who in turn was dazzled by the brilliance of the demon. Hanuman shook off his wonder and, with irrepressible anger, quickly jumped forward and gave the demon a powerful blow to the head. Both of them increased their body size and fought fiercely, inflicting injuries and causing blood to flow down their huge bodies. Repeatedly, Mairavana would gradually tire, but then, as if by magic, he would regain his vigor. Hanuman became concerned the longer the fight continued. Dawn was approaching and time was running out. While fighting, they fell to the floor near the room of Durdandi. She realized her conscience could no longer support the evil ways of her brother. She yelled,
Hanuman, my brother's life energies are not in his body. In the distant hill, you will find a cave covered with a big stone. 5 honeybees live inside, and they are his 5 life energies.
Mairavana was furious with his sister, but before he could react, he found himself firmly pinned to the ground by a giant foot. Hanuman had grown sky high and held Mairavana under his foot. Stretching his other leg to the hill, Hanuman found the cave and trampled the 5 beasts, killing them instantly. Mairavana died at once. The celestials praised Hanuman and showered him with flowers, singing,
సీతమ్మను వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయుడా శోకాలను పాపవయ్య మాకు దూరమే సీతమ్మను వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయుడా శోకాలను పాపవయ్య మాకు దూరమే
పైనాకుని శిఖరాలను ముట్టినావట ఆ సింహిక కడుపులో దూరినావట వాయు పదములను దాటి ఎగిరినావట ఛాయాగ్రహ గుండెలు చీచినావట సీతమ్మలు వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయుడా శోకాలను పాపవయ్య మాకు దూరమే సీతమ్మను చూచి ఓదార్చినావట ముద్రికిచ్చి శిరోమణి తెచ్చినావట సారావణు మించినట్టి మైరావణ్ సంహరించి శ్రీరాముని ప్రాణము నిలిపినావట
సీతమ్మలు వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయుడా శోకాలను పాపవయ్య మాకు కూడరే
విద్యలిచ్చి వక్పటత్వం అప్పజేతువు మాకు సచిదనంద బోధమి వయ్య మాకు
సీతమ్మను వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయడా శోకాలను బాబవయ్య మాకు కూడరే.
The refrain, సీతమ్మను వెదకినట్టి తోకరాయడా శోకాలను బాపవయ్య మాకు కూడా. ఓ హనుమాన్, దో యు ఆర్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఏప్, యూ లొకేటెడ్ అండ్ కన్సోల్డ్ సీత ఇన్ లంక. సిమిలర్లీ, కైండ్లీ రిమూవ్ ఆర్ గ్రీఫ్ ఆల్సో. వర్స్ 1, మైనాకుని శిఖరాలను ముట్టినావట, ఆ సింహిక కడుపులోన దూరినావట. You gently touched the mountain Mainaka as a gesture of friendship. You entered the mouth of Simhika, pounced upon her heart and killed her in a moment. Verse 2.
Vayupathamu lanu daati egirinavata, chayagraham gundelanu chilchinavata.
You soared higher into the sky, crossing the paths of the wind. You fragmented the heart of the shadow-grabbing demoness Simhika. Verse 3.
సీతమ్మను చూచి ఓదార్చినావట, ముద్రికిచ్చి శిరోమణిని తెచ్చినావట.
యు కన్సోల్డ్ సీత ఇన్ లంక అండ్ గేవ్ హర్ లార్డ్ రామాస్ రింగ్. షీ ఇన్ టర్న్ గేవ్ యూ హర్ చూడామణి, ద హెడ్ ఆర్నమెంట్ టు బి హ్యాండెడ్ ఓవర్ టు శ్రీరామ యాజ్ అ టోకెన్ ఆఫ్ హర్ ఎఫెక్షన్. వర్స్ 4.
ఆ రావణు మించినట్టి మైరావణు సంహరించి శ్రీరాముని ప్రాణమ్ములు నిలిపినావట.
యు కిల్డ్ మైరావణ, who was more powerful than Ravana, and rescued Sri Rama. Verse 5.
Vidyalichi vakpatutva mabbachetuvu sachidananda bodham ivayyamaku.
Kindly grant us knowledge of all aspects and the power of good speech. Also kindly enlighten us with your precept of sat chit ananda, truth, knowledge, bliss. At once, Hanuman removed the shackles of Durdandi and her family. She took him to Sri Rama and Lakshmana, and he collected the box which contained them. Then with the lake water brought by Durdandi, Hanuman performed Abhishekam, a ritual bath to her son Neelamegha, and crowned him king of Patala. Carrying the box, Hanuman reached the palace gate to find Matsyavallabha waiting for him. His son again expressed regret for the fight. Hanuman consoled him and appointed him as the new king's bodyguard. With the speed of the wind, Hanuman returned to Lanka. After placing Sri Rama and Lakshmana in a sleeping position, he again created his tail dome around them. He sat very still, meditating on Lord Rama, and by his penance, the effects of Mairavana's powder disappeared. Sri Rama and Lakshmana woke up feeling that they had slept for a long time. The brothers immediately returned to the battlefield, accompanied by Hanuman and Vibhishana. Being ever humble, Hanuman never revealed the night's events to anyone, and Vibhishana heartily praised him for his silence. Chapter 18. Moving Mountains. Finally, the ten-headed Rakshasa King Ravana entered the battlefield and viciously began attacking the Vanara army. Both Sugriva and another Vanara, Gavaksha, fell down unconscious. Witnessing this, Lord Rama and Lakshmana were about to counterattack Ravana. As they were setting off, Hanuman approached and asked,
"When I am here, why do you go to fight him?"
Hanuman then jumped on Ravana. It was a wonderful sight to see them fiercely wrestle each other. At one point, they both simultaneously fell down unconscious. Meanwhile, Lakshmana was hit by one of Indrajit's arrows and also lay unconscious on the battlefield. Ravana recovered first and used this opportunity to abduct the unconscious Lakshmana. However, Ravana found him impossible to lift as Lakshmana's weight had increased many times. Lakshmana was an incarnation of Adishesha, the multi-headed serpent that served as the bed of Lord Vishnu. Just then, Hanuman regained consciousness and seeing this, leaped to attack Ravana. With a single blow, Ravana fell down unconscious again. Hanuman lifted Lakshmana and took him to safety.
Hanuman then carried Lord Rama on his shoulder and placed him in front of Ravana. When Ravana came to senses, Sri Rama challenged him to a personal fight riding in chariots. Ravana readily agreed. In this duel, Sri Rama broke Ravana's bow, killed his chariot driver, destroyed the chariot wheels, and shattered his crown to pieces. Ravana fell down unconscious for the third time. When Ravana's head cleared, he got up slowly. He was very weak and could not easily stand up. He was amazed at the power of Rama's arrows and felt that he was about to die. Quite unexpectedly, he heard Sri Rama say,
"O Ravana, you are a very great warrior. Today you fought many opponents and came to me at the end. You appear to be weak. Do not be afraid. Go home now and take rest. Tomorrow, come to me straight away, prepared to fight. You will then taste my valor."
There could have been no greater insult to Ravana. He thought,
"Even if I win the war tomorrow, my life will still be considered a waste."
As he could do nothing else, Ravana returned home. The next day, Sri Rama killed Ravana's giant brother Kumbhakarna and also Atikaya, another powerful Rakshasa. Filled only with thoughts of revenge, Ravana's most beloved son Indrajit swooped down on the enemy forces. With his arrows, he injured and killed thousands of Vanaras who were helpless against his fury. He then aimed the deadly Brahmastra at them. Sri Rama and Lakshmana saw what was about to happen. They remembered that if one bows down and reverentially prostrates to Brahmastra, it will do no harm. They conveyed this information to their commanders, who ordered the soldiers to lie down and not move a muscle. When Indrajit saw no soldiers standing and the ground littered with bodies, he believed he had killed them all. He returned to Ravana to share the good news. Hanuman rose to his feet first and surveyed the damage. It was disheartening to see so many warriors severely wounded or dead. While searching the troops, Vibhishana came across the great bear warrior Jambavan, who was unconscious. Arrows pierced his eyes and his old body was covered with wounds. Vibhishana mildly stroked his back and softly asked,
"Grandfather, are you alive?"
Jambavan regained consciousness and said in a whisper,
"It is not important if I am alive. Tell me whether Hanuman still lives. If he is alive, then all of us could be alive."
Hanuman quickly came to his side. Jambavan told him,
"Hanuman, you and you alone can restore the lives of the Vanara warriors. In the Himalayan mountain range between Mount Kailas and Rishabha mountain, you will find the Oshadi Shikaram. It is the peak that contains all medicinal herbs. It is in a remote, hidden spot. On this unique peak, 4 medicinal plants grow with powerful healing properties. They are Mritasanjeevani, Vishalyakarani, Savarnyakarani, and Sandhanakarani. They restore life, rejoin broken bones, restore one's health, and reunite disassembled body parts respectively. Pray to the deities of these plants. Identify the herbs and bring them here. This is the only way to bring our dead Vanara warriors back to life and restore the health of the injured ones."
Repeating,
"Jai Sri Ram!"
Victory to Sri Rama. Hanuman increased his size, leapt into the sky and crossed the ocean. Flying non-stop, he landed beside Mount Kailasa and located the peak containing the medicinal herbs. But there were no deities to be found. When they saw Hanuman's gigantic, fierce form, they were afraid and disappeared. Dismayed and with no time to spare, Hanuman picked up the entire peak at its base and held it in the palm of his right hand. Holding his mace in the other hand, he quickly flew non-stop back to Lanka and stood amidst his comrades. The celestials showered him with flowers, singing,
Sanjeevi Parvatadhari Jagati Prabhanjanatmakayeko Jayati Sanjeevi Parvatadhari Jagati Prabhanjanatmakayeko Jayati
సుదూర లంక పురోత్తమా ఉల్లంఘ సింధు హిమాలయాతో
నిపజయోజీవి పర్వతారి జగది ప్రభంజనాత్మకేకో జయది
కరాగ్ర కందుక పిండి విధాయ పర్వత శృంగోతం పునశ్చ దక్షిణ కాష్టగా ప్రచార సత్వరమ ప్రేద
సంజీవి పర్వతధారి జగతి ప్రభంజనాత్మకేకో జయతి
విపక్షకో వా ఖగేశ్వర సపక్షకో వా నగేశ్వరో నభశ్చరో యత్కయత్యలోకయత్యం సురావళి
సంజీవి పర్వతధారి జగతి ప్రభంజనాత్మకేకో జయతి
మరుత్తమారక జైభవ రఘుత్వరక్షక జైభవ త్వం సంజీవ జైభవ సచ్చిదానంద జైభవ
సంజీవి పర్వతధారి జగతి ప్రభంజనాత్మకేకో జయతి
ది రిఫ్రెయిన్ సంజీవి పర్వతధారి జగతి ప్రభంజనాత్మజ ఏకో జయతి. దేర్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఇన్ ద ఎంటైర్ వరల్డ్ ఇన్ ఆల్ ఇటర్నిటీ హూ కుడ్ క్యారీ ద సంజీవిని ద లైఫ్ గివింగ్ ఎర్బ్ మౌంటైన్. హీ ఇస్ హనుమాన్ ద సన్ ఆఫ్ విండ్ టు హూమ్ ఐ ప్రోస్ట్రేట్. వర్స్ 1. సుదూర లంకా పురోత్తమాత్ ఉల్లంఘ్య సింధుం ధరామపి హిమాలయాద్రౌ నిపత్యయో ముమోచ నైవోచ్ఛ్వాసమహో. Without even a sigh, he flew over the mighty ocean from Lanka to the Himalayas to retrieve the healing mountain. Verse 2. Karagra kanduka pindi bhutam vidhaya parvata shringottam sam punascha dakshina kashthagami chachara sattvaram abhredabhre. Carrying the mountain as easily as a ball in his palm, he returned crossing the ocean to reach Lanka. Verse 3. Vipakshako va khageshwara sapakshako va nageshwaro nabhaschcharoyam kakkayiti vyalokayadyam suravali. The celestials were astonished to see Hanuman cross the ocean, and they wondered whether he was Garuda, the eagle vehicle of Lord Vishnu without wings, or a mountain with wings. Verse 4. Marut kumaraka jayibhava రఘుత్ఖ రక్షక జయీభవ త్వం సంజీవన జయీభవ సచిదానంద జయీభవ. ఓ సన్ ఆఫ్ వాయు, విక్టరీ టు యూ. ఓ సేవియర్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ రామా, విక్టరీ టు యూ. యూ ఆర్ సంజీవన, ద లైఫ్ గివర్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్. ఓ ద ఎంబాడిమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ట్రూత్, నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ బ్లెస్, విక్టరీ టు యూ. వెన్ ద ఫైన్ ఫ్రేగ్రెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద హీలింగ్ హెర్బ్స్ టచ్ దేర్ నోసెస్, మిరకల్స్ అకర్డ్. The dead vanaras came back to life, broken bones were rejoined and flawlessly healed, arrows which pierced the injured fell away, and all wounds were instantly healed. The soldiers regained perfect health. The dead demons could have also benefited from the herb's healing properties, but there were no dead demon bodies to be found. Earlier in the war, an arrogant Ravana thought,
if anyone were to know that a demon warrior had been killed by a lowly monkey, my fame would be tarnished.
So he ordered his soldiers to retrieve the dead bodies and throw them into the deep sea, where the fishes happily consumed them. Ravana would daily declare,
"Today, so many monkeys perished without the loss of a single demon warrior."
Once the Vanaras were healed, Hanuman took to the sky, returned the healing mountain to its proper place and sped back to Lanka. In the war that night, Lakshmana vehemently plunged headlong into battle, aiming at Indrajit. Lakshmana enforced his Indrastra, the powerful weapon of Lord Indra, with a Rama mantra and sanctified it with a prayer.
Dharmatma Satya Sandhacha Ramo Dasharatir Yadi Paurushecha Pratidvandvaka Sharainam Jai Ravani.
If Lord Rama, a son of Dasharatha, is truthful, if he is the invincible warrior, and if he has the greatest power, O arrow, kill Indrajit, a son of Ravana.
With this single arrow, Indrajit was slain. With renewed vengeance, Ravana returned to the battlefield, attacking Sri Rama and Lakshmana. Ravana used the weapon Shakti, power, and aimed it at Lakshmana's heart. Lakshmana fell to the ground unconscious. Now Lord Rama fiercely attacked Ravana. The demon king soon became weak. The driver of his chariot sped him away to safety. Sri Rama placed Lakshmana's head on his lap and cried. Hanuman knew what needed to be done without even being told. He retrieved the mountain of healing herbs and saw that Lakshmana's life energy was restored. Hanuman replaced the mountain and returned to Lanka once more. The next day, Sri Rama and Ravana fought in a fierce one-on-one combat. Lord Rama beheaded Ravana's 10 heads 101 times, but each time new heads sprouted in their place. At a loss as to how to kill this demon, Sri Rama received counsel from Indra's chariot driver, Matali. Lord Indra had offered his chariot and driver to assist Sri Rama in this war. Following his advice, Sri Rama aimed the Brahmastra at Ravana's stomach, where his life force was contained. The demon king died and the war ended. Fragrant flowers rained from the sky, and the earth and heavens were filled with praises, singing the glory of Lord Rama.
Rakendu bimbananam Ramam shamala vega komala rujim Rakendu bimbananam Rakshogram harijachitam Raghuvaram Ratnojvalat kundalam Ramam shamala vega komala rujim Rakendu bimbananam Rakendu bimbananam Rajivacha mamanusham Pranabalam Program Ramanugraham Program Ramanugraham Ramam Shyamala Megha Komala Ruchim Rakendu bimbananam Rakendu bimbananam Rajendram Ramaniya Rupa Masakrita Jaye Jagat Mohanam Ramam Shyamala Megha Komala Ruchim Rakendu Bimbananam Rakendu Bimbananam.
The refrain: Ramam Shyamala Megha Komala Ruchim Rakendu Bimbananam. Your nature is to give bliss. You are dark and radiant as a rain cloud. Your face is as beautiful as the full moon. Verse 1. Rakshoghnam Ravijarchitam Raghuvaram Ratnojvalat Kundalam. You destroy the demons. You are worshipped by Sugriva, the son of Surya, the sun god. You are the crown jewel of the Raghu dynasty. Your ear ornaments are glowing with precious gems. Verse 2. Rajivaksham amanusham ranabala program ramanugraham. Your eyes are like lotus flowers. In battle, you are extraordinarily ferocious and strong. You are loving towards Sita. Verse 3. Rajendram ramaniya rupam asakrit dhyaye jaganmohanam. You are the king of kings. Your handsome form is enchanting in all the worlds. Chapter 19. A humble hero. The victory of Lord Rama's army triggered a series of events. Ravana's righteous brother Vibhishana was publicly crowned the new king of Lanka. Sri Rama and Sita Devi were reunited. However, her chastity was in question after staying so long in a demon's household. To remove any doubt, Sita Devi voluntarily entered a fire pit, saying,
"If I have maintained my purity in thought, word, and deed, let the fire god Agni not burn or harm me."
In that moment, Agni, the fire god, rose out of the flames carrying Sita in his arms. With her clothes and jewels completely untouched by the flames, Agni presented Sita Devi to Lord Rama. Riding in the Pushpaka Vimana, the flying palace, Sri Rama, Sita Devi, Lakshmana and the entire Vanara army returned home. Lord Rama was reunited with his brother Bharata, who had been governing Ayodhya in his absence. There was a grand coronation ceremony as Sri Rama assumed his rightful position on the throne. Hanuman was present throughout all of these events, yet the ever humble servant of Lord Rama was virtually silent. On the occasion of the coronation, Sri Rama gave a unique gem-studded golden necklace to Sita Devi, saying,
"Gift this to anyone you like."
Sita Devi slowly scanned the royal assembly comprised of many great warriors of different races, celestials, demons from Vibhishana's kingdom, humans and Vanaras. Her gaze stopped on Hanuman and she gifted the beautiful piece of jewelry to him. Sri Rama was delighted with her choice. So was the royal court, as the hall reverberated with joyous applause and cheers for their hero, Hanuman.
Jai Hanuman!
Sri Rama then took up the administration of his kingdom. One day, as he was sitting leisurely, he thought,
"At last, the problems and persecutions caused by the demons have ended. I can now make efforts to re-establish and uplift dharma, righteousness, among the people."
Just when he was feeling satisfied, Lord Rama heard a voice from the sky say,
"Sri Rama, are you content with only this? Do you believe that it was such a great achievement to cross the ocean for 100 yojanas and kill the 10-headed Ravana? Hanuman has killed another more powerful Ravana, my Ravana, in Patala. Of course, you killed the sparrow-like Ravana of Lanka. Another demon still exists who is many times more powerful than the other two, having 100 heads. He is called Shatakantha Ravana. There are 7 oceans in space between the earth and heaven. The demon resides on an island among them named Shatakantha Lanka. It is a very great distance from the earth. Shatakantha Ravana is very lazy, so he has not yet waged war against anyone. If he decides to attack, even the celestials would not be safe from his evil powers. Sri Rama, it will be difficult for even you to kill him. Yet, until he is gone, you cannot remain fearless. Ever since you killed Ravana on earth, Shatakantha Ravana's anger towards you has been increasing. So you must devise a strategy to kill him before he makes the first move."
Lord Rama felt weak hearing these words. He called a meeting of his 3 brothers and Hanuman and relayed the warning message. he said.
Look at the great effort it took to simply cross 100 yojanas and how strenuous it was to kill the 10-headed Ravana. Now the voice tells us of a 100-headed demon on an island as far away as the galaxy of stars in the seven oceans. Even supposing that the five of us could reach the island, how could we fight without an army? Plus, we have no idea about this demon's military strength. I am at a loss to find the proper strategy. Can any of you give me a suggestion?
No one said a word. Then Sri Rama and his three brothers asked Hanuman.
Hanuman, you are very powerful and smart. What hope do we have if you are silent?
When they praised him, Hanuman recollected his power and said,
O Lord Ramachandra, you are really Lord Vishnu. Where is the need for you to seek the advice of others? Anyway, since you asked, I will express what I feel. If you so agree, please sit on my right shoulder with Sita Devi. I will place your three brothers on my left shoulder. If you are concerned that your wife may be afraid while I fly, remember that she is the mother of the universe. However, I will not fly. My feet will remain here on earth and I will extend my body up to reach Shatakanta's island. Then your entire army of soldiers, chariots and horses can climb up my tail using its hairs as steps, thus reaching the demon's island. Kindly accept this method.
The four brothers were amazed at Hanuman's plan. They praised him, saying,
What a brilliant plan! Well done, Hanuman!
Messages were sent to Sugriva and Vibhishana to bring their armies to join Ayodhya's. At an auspicious time, the assembled forces were ready to march. Lord Rama and Sita were seated on Hanuman's right shoulder and the three brothers on his left. Just as Sri Rama was about to command Hanuman to extend himself, the voice from the sky was heard again, saying,
Sri Rama, do you believe this island to be just like Ravana's Lanka, surrounded by hills and a stone fortress wall? It is not. Shatakanta Lanka is protected by a giant wall of fire. If Hanuman extends his body that far, his head will be burned to ashes. And even if he could withstand the heat, it would mean a certain death to you and to your armies. Beware!
Sri Rama was stunned and his face became very pale. However, Hanuman was undaunted and roared,
Hoom!
This is a powerful mantra. Then he spun his long, powerful tail with great force, creating a giant propeller. By the tremendous wind power that it generated, the flames around the island were dispersed far away into the deep oceans. Once again, the celestials were impressed by the yet another wonderful feat of Hanuman. Then, according to plan, the various armies ascended the step-like hairs of Hanuman's tail and arrived at Shatakanta Lanka. Shatakanta noticed the sudden disappearance of the wall of flames around his kingdom. Giving up his laziness, he went to the window and looked out. By that time, the armies were fast approaching his capital. Shatakanta's anger knew no bounds. He alerted his military forces to prepare for immediate battle. As soon as Sri Rama, his brothers and the armies entered the city, the demon forces attacked. Lord Rama was ready for the fight and he challenged the enemy with limitless bravery. At the same time, Sugriva, Angada and Vibhishana came from one direction with their armies. And the three brothers, Lakshmana, Bharata and Shatrughna, approached with their armies from the other direction. Hanuman did not enter the battle. He calmly sat and continuously sang the glory of Lord Rama.
రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు. పాదమెత్తి తాకెను బండరాతి తునకను, పాదమంటి స్వచ్ఛమైన నామ ఒకటి మోయ్. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, శివుని ధనసు నెత్తెను సీత మనసు నొత్తెను, రాక్షసాళి బ్రతుకులెల్ల పిరిగి ముక్కలాయను. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, గంగ నీటిలోన కూడు పాదయుగలి కడిగెను, గంగ తల్లి పొంగిపోయి నింగినంటి ఎగిరెను. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, రెక్క తెగిన పిట్ట కొరకు వెక్కి వెక్కి ఏడ్చెను, అశ్రుతర్పణము చేసి అమరలోకమిచ్చెను. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, పడిచినట్టి రాతి విడచి కోతి కౌగలించెను, రక్తి కన్న తనకు భక్తి రమ్య మనసు చాటెను. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, మనిషి కూడ నిలపి కొలుచు మహిమలెన్నో చేశను, సచిదనంద యోగమిచ్చి సాధు జనల గాచెను. రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు, రమ్యమైన దేవుడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు.
ద రిఫ్రెయిన్, రాముడమ్మ రాముడు రమ్యమైన దేవుడు. లార్డ్ రామా ఇస్ ఎ చార్మింగ్ డైటీ. వర్స్ 1, పాదమెత్తి తాకెను బండరాతి తునకను, పాల వంటి స్వచ్ఛమైన భామ ఒకతే పుట్టెను. హీ టచ్డ్ ఎ రాక్ విత్ హిస్ ఫీట్. అట్ వన్స్ ఎ లేడీ అహల్య యాజ్ ప్యూర్ అండ్ బ్రైటెస్ట్ మిల్క్ ఎమినేటెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇట్. వర్స్ 2, శివుని ధనుసు నెత్తెను సీత మనసు నొత్తెను, రాక్షసాళి బ్రతుకులెల్ల విరిగి ముక్కలాయెను. హీ లిఫ్టెడ్ లార్డ్ శివాస్ బౌ, హిస్ వాలర్ టచ్డ్ సీతాస్ హార్ట్. అట్ వన్స్ ద లైవ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఈవిల్ డీమన్స్ వర్ డూమ్డ్. వర్స్ 3, భార్గవుండు మండిపడుచు దండడింపు చేసెను, వాణి ఊర్ధ్వగతులు తూలి వచ్చి పాదమంటెను. పరశురామ షోడ్ హిస్ ఫ్యూరీ, లార్డ్ రామా హంబుల్డ్ హిస్ ప్రైడ్ and nullified his power to reach the celestial worlds beyond the earth. Verse 4, ganga neeti lona guhudu padayugali kadigenu, ganga talli pongi poyi ningi nanti yegirenu. The boatman Guha washed Lord Rama's feet with devotion in the river Ganga. Overjoyed, the river rose as high as the sky. Verse 5, rekka tegina pitta koraku vekki vekki yedchenu, అశ్రుతర్పణము చేసి అమరలోకమిచ్చెను. లార్డ్ రామా వెప్ట్ బిటర్లీ అపాన్ సీయింగ్ ద మార్టలీ వూండెడ్ ఈగల్ జటాయు. లేటర్ హీ పర్ఫార్మ్డ్ ద స్టిప్యులేటెడ్ లాస్ట్ రైట్స్ ఆఫ్ ద డెడ్ ఈగల్ అండ్ బ్లెస్డ్ హిస్ డిపార్టెడ్ సోల్ విత్ ద బూన్ ఆఫ్ ఫర్ ఎవర్ రిమైనింగ్ ఇన్ హెవెన్. వర్స్ 6, వలచినట్టి నాతి విడచి కోతి కౌగలించెను, రక్తి కన్న తనకు భక్తి రమ్యమనుచు చాటెను. Lord Rama drove away the demoness Shurpanakha when she approached him with lustful thoughts. Lord Rama embraced Hanuman with love and affection as a gesture of gratitude for his sincere services. Thus, Lord Rama proclaimed by his example that he cherishes bhakti, devotion, and not rakti, lust. Verse 7,
మనిషి అగుట నిలిపి కొనుచు మహిమలెన్నో చేసెను, సచిదానంద యోగమిచ్చి సాధు జనుల గాచెను.
లార్డ్ రామా బిహేవ్స్ యాజ్ ఎ హ్యూమన్ బీయింగ్. ఈవెన్ ఇన్ హిస్ హ్యూమన్ ఫార్మ్, లార్డ్ రామా పర్ఫార్మ్స్ సూపర్ న్యాచురల్ అండ్ సూపర్ హ్యూమన్ మిరకల్స్. లార్డ్ రామా గిఫ్ట్స్ సత్ చిత్ ఆనంద టు హిస్ డివోటీస్ అండ్ ప్రొటెక్ట్స్ ద పాయస్ పీపుల్ ఫర్ ఎవర్ అండ్ ఎవర్. Shri Rama directly attacked Shatakantha and a fierce duel ensued. Finally, Lord Rama began cutting off Shatakantha's heads. However, just like his counterpart on earth, the demon's heads sprouted anew again and again. To make matters worse, whenever his blood fell to the ground, a new Shatakantha would emanate from each drop. These duplicates also joined in the fight. Shri Rama realized that the situation was deteriorating and becoming more dangerous every moment. thousands of Shatakantas appeared and surrounded him and his brothers. They shot countless arrows at the four brothers. The brothers and even Sri Rama fell down unconscious, recovered, then continued to fight. This scene was repeated several times. Sita Devi had not accompanied them to battle. Now, for the first time, she came to see the fight. When she saw her husband and his three brothers in an unconscious state, she became very afraid. She was deep in prayer, thinking about what she should do. At that moment, the great saint Garga manifested in her presence. He encouraged her and gave her the Upadesha, the initiation of a powerful chant, the Dwadashakshara Hanuman Mantra.
The Hanuman Mantra containing 12 syllables.
Sita Devi praised Hanuman in song.
Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Jaya Jaya Mula Pranesha Mula Vidya Parinasha Jaya Jaya Brahma Jnanesha Shudra Jnana Pratipasa Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Vidya Vivechana Kapivira Sneha Gunanvita Ramasaka Kantimaya Duta Kamaniya Apratihata Gati Sampanna Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Kambi Marutsuta Namasi Akila Marutgana Sarosi Dukkha Nivarana Shilosi Nunam Pranavakarosi Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Hanuman Tvam Ripu Samhari Harihara Rupi Shubhakari Veda Shikatat Sanchari Sachidananda Sikidari Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya
The refrain Jagadabhyayana Anjaneya Vimala Niranjana Anjaneya Anjaneya, you fulfill the desires of your devotees to their satisfaction. You are ever pure and dispassionate. Verse 1 Jaya Jaya Mula Pranesha Mula Vidya Parinasha Jaya Jaya Brahma Jnanesha Chuddha Jnana Pratibhasa You are the Lord of Life Energy. Victory to you. You are the only one who can remove the deep-seated ignorance of the devotee. You are the Lord of Divine Knowledge. Victory to you. Kindly enlighten me with perfect knowledge. Verse 2 Nitya Vivechana Kapivira Sneha Gunanvita Ramasakha Kanti Mayadbhuta Kamaniya Apratihata Gati Sampanna You are always wise. You are the best of the Vanara warriors. Friendliness is your natural tendency. You are an intimate friend of Lord Rama. You are ever brilliant and handsome. Your courage is astonishing and nothing can stop you. Verse 3 Tvam hi marutsuta namasi akhila marudgana sarosi dukkha nivarana shilosi noonam pranavakarosi You are Maruti, the son of wind. You are the combined form of all the celestials. Your mission is to remove the grief of your devotees. You are the form of Omkara, the auspicious sound. Verse 4 Hanuman Tvam Ripu Samhari Harihara Rupi Shubhakari Veda Shikha Tata Sanchari Sachidananda Sthiti Dhari You kill the enemies with your might. Hanuman, you are the single form of Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu. You are the giver of good fortune to your devotees. The Vedas are full of your praise. You are in the sublime state of Sat, Chit, Ananda, truth, knowledge, and bliss. Sita Devi chanted the powerful Hanuman mantra that the sage had given her. After some time, Sri Hanuman with five faces manifested in her presence.
Vanaram mukamekam tu dvitiyam simhavatrakam tritiyam karunam vatram chaturtam saukaram mukham hayananam panchamancha abhyekaikam nayanaistribihi dashabahu samapetam dashayuda samanvitam tada prabhruti gatitakam panchasyo hanumaniti rupam tasya bhavuyadvat rudrasya puraghatinah.
The Lord of the Vanaras has five faces: ape, lion, eagle, boar, and horse. Each has three eyes. He has 10 hands. His form is as bright as that of Lord Shiva at the time of burning the three demons, Tripura. This form is called Panchamukha Hanuman. Upon seeing this universal form of Hanuman, Sita Devi assumed the fierce form of goddess Kalika. She took a bow in her hand and roared like a lioness. Hanuman placed her on his shoulder and took her to the battlefront. Sita Devi, in the form of Kalika, held several weapons in her hands. Arrows flew from her bow like a torrential rain at the thousands of Shatakantha forms. But the demon's blood drops continued to emanate new forms, and even Kalika found it difficult to fight the continually increasing number of demons. As her vehicle, Hanuman was doing the japa of Ramanama. Realizing his assistance was needed, he extended his tail for miles and covered the ground with it like a giant rope carpet. Thereafter, the dripping blood never touched the ground, so new demon forms ceased to appear.
Ekapatni prato ramo yajyakam pati devata patatyanena bhanena shatanana shiro mahat.
If my husband upholds the vow of having only one wife and is never fascinated by another female, may the head of Shatakanta fall down by this arrow.
After uttering these words, Kalika shot the arrow at the demon, severing his remaining head. It did not reappear, and Shatakanta fell dead like an uprooted tree. The celestials rained fragrant flowers on the fierce form of Kalika. The entire island resounded with their chants.
Jai Jai Kalika! Jai Jai Kalika!
Victory! Victory to Mother Kalika!
Kalika! Kalika! Kaligam kaligam kalitarunda malikam bhaje Himagirindra balikam Shritamunindra balikam Adanataga dhulikam Kayamidana kelikam Kaligam kaligam kalitarunda malikam bhaje Suravipaksha vyalikam Kasadudara chulikam Jani vinasha moolikam Gadavimoga jalikam Kaligam, Kaligam, Kalitarunda Malikam Bhaje.
కాళదేవ సంగత కలిత పంచకృత్య పాలకాల వల్లభా కలసు కాల విగ్రహ కాళికాం కాళికాం కలితరుండ మాలికాం భజే ఘోర ఘోర రూపికాం మార మార నాయికాం అమృత భావ నాళికాం సచిదానంద కాళికాం 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 కలితరుండ మాలికాం భజే కాళికాం కాళికాం కలితరుండ మాలికాం భజే కలితరుండ మాలికాం భజే
The refrain Kalikam Kalikam Kalita Runda Malikam Bhaje. I worship the dark mother Kalika who is adorned with a garland of skulls. Verse 1 Hima Girindra Balikam Shrita Munindra Palikam Hata Nataagha Dhulikam Laya Vidhana Kelikam. I praise the daughter of Himavan, the king of the snow-clad mountain. She protects all saints and sages. She destroys the sins of her devotees, for her dissolution is a sport. Verse 2 Sura vipaksha vyalikam, lasa dudara chulikam, jani vinasha moolikam, gata vimoha jalikam. I worship Mother Kalika, who destroys demons. She has long, beautiful hair. She destroys worldliness and worldly passions. Verse 3 Karadhrito grashulikam, rudhira ranjitalikam, asura runda malikam, mahita mantra kelikam. I offer prayers to Mother Kalika, who wields the deadly weapon, the spear. She decorates her forehead with blood. She wears a garland of demon skulls. Mother Kalika sports with great powerful mantras. Verse 4 Kala Deva Sangatam Karita Pancha Krityakam Kala Kala Vallabham Kala Sukala Vigraham. I worship the beautiful and dark Mother Kalika, who is the consort of one who has transcended time. She is ever engaged in the five activities of creation, sustenance, withdrawal, blessing, and renewal. Verse 5 Ghora Ghora Rupikam Mara Mara Nayikam Amrita Bhava Nalikam Sachidananda Kalikam. I worship Mother Kalika, whose form is frightening. She is the queen of the one who has destroyed Manmatha, the god of desire. She channels Amrita, the nectar of immortality. She is herself Sat Chit Ananda, ultimate reality, perfect knowledge, and eternal bliss.
Jai Jai Kalika! Jai Jai Kalika!
Hearing the loud cheers, the four brothers regained consciousness. Then Sita and Hanuman withdrew their universal forms and appeared in their original forms. Sri Rama came to know about the heroic deeds of his wife and his friend. He was immensely pleased and praised them with all his heart. Then he asked them to show him their Vishwarupa, the universal forms. Sita Devi and Hanuman felt shy. They prostrated to him and said softly,
O Lord, please do not be offended, but you cannot bear to see those fierce forms. Kindly do not insist.
Sri Rama smiled sweetly and praised them further, saying,
Though you will not reveal it, I know your power and effectiveness. It is difficult for anyone, even the celestials, to comprehend the extent of your strength, splendor, and amazing abilities. Whoever thinks of you with devotion will obtain everything precious.
Hanuman ensured the safe return of all back to the earth. Sri Rama resumed his administrative duties as the king of Ayodhya. Hanuman remained his ever faithful devotee whose only desire was to serve his Lord. When it was time for Lord Rama's incarnation to end, for him to leave his physical body, Sri Rama asked Hanuman not to accompany him to the forest. He reminded Hanuman that Hanuman is a Chiranjeevi, immortal, and that Rama would always reside in his heart. Hanuman obediently remained on the mountain Gandhamadana, doing japa of Ramanama and singing his praises. Through eternity, Lord Hanuman is ever engaged in the practice of Nada Yoga, union with the divine through divine music, and the ceaseless chanting of Lord Rama's name. In the age that followed, Dwapara Yuga, Lord Vishnu incarnated as Lord Krishna. As always, Sri Hanuman was serving him in the fulfillment of his mission. He humbled the pride of Bhima, Arjuna, and Satyabhama. In the future Kalpa, he will become Lord Brahma, the creator. In the present age of Kali Yuga, Hanuman serves to develop deep devotion to Lord Rama by spreading the message of the significance of singing Lord Rama's glory. Whenever and wherever the glory of Lord Rama's name is sung with faith and devotion, there Hanuman dwells to bless the devotees. In this technological age, Lord Hanuman's energy is predominantly powerful for blessing and protection. He must be remembered, revered, and worshipped. Throughout the world, Hanuman gives darshan, divine blessings, to millions of people through small murtis, idols in temples, or as towering monuments. Thousands of people daily remember him by singing the Hanuman Chalisa, composed by Sri Goswami Tulasidas Ji. This powerful 40-verse chant brings peace, bliss, and liberation from worldly bondage to devotees. By his example, Hanuman reminds us to be fearless and selfless in our devotion and service to God and mankind. As the annihilator of evil-mindedness, pride, and unwanted thoughts, Hanuman is silently ever present with hands joined over his head, pouring out tears of joy everywhere, wherever, whenever the glory of Lord Rama is being sung.
Yatra yatra ragunatha kirtanam tatra tatra krutamastakanjali bhashvabari paripurna lochanam marutim namadarasha sandhanam marutim namadarasha sandhanam marutim namadarasha
sandhanam. Jai Hanuman, Jai Guru Dattaya.